Hey guys, your workers, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Nifine Hardcore mode where last time off. He kicked it into high gear. I dominated my last two games. In the league. He scored 10 goals, conceding 0. It was boss. If you didn't see that episode, I highly recommend going
and watching it when you have the time.
In this episode, you will see the debut of my new keeper, Lloris Karius, who I signed from Cologne in a swap deal that's a... Or my other, their goalkeeper going the, go to, Cologne. So. Well, big episode. As you can see, I also put in Tapia and Fitch into the center mid because of how tired Valhanna and Dohamedy are. Look at that. They will run out of stamina way too quickly in this match. So, it's just not worth it. So, well, this is the team. I'm once again playing this NEC team. I still don't know what that stands for. But it doesn't really matter. Let's get in and get the points.
But warm actually isn't the word, really, not here in the stadium, with the snow coming down.
Yeah, it's a bit chilly. I want to keep moving down there, but the snow for the moment...
We got a nice early goal to get started.
And for Feyenoord, this is how they're going to line up.
And if I run into the opposition, Kramer, who was very good in the last episode.
Yeah, that's right. I'm just looking at the two wide lads up.
Trying desperately to keep his... place.
See how they get on.
He can't keep it on the pitch. He's gone out for a throw. That's dealt with the problem. He's given possession away here.
Stojanovic.
Well, he's got support here.
And
got a chance to cross. It's another slip and a slide in the snow here.
Tackle fairly for the ball. And Burke. Etc. is wayward, to say the very least.
He's got a cross to make that interception. He saw it.
Fuck again. Great ball, couch, go, go Dirk, run, run, her Dutch legs off, you want a corner, don't bother doing, you know, the sensible thing, like, you know, jumping! Jumping would have been the sensible thing there, but, you know.
Good link up. Tackle is strong.
When you regret nothing, you, win, I guess.
The cross comes in now.
Kramer, there we go. He's continuing his good form. I should have brought in his trigger to challenge him from the very start. He's playing superb.
the ability to use the net.
I'd say the very least. 17 goals now this season for Kramer.
Well, I don't know. The game's played on the pitch, but not on play.
He's heavily involved in the goal fest. That was the last episode, like I said.
I think we can take it as red.
No, no. Ever since I signed Traore, Kramer's performances have been better. Right, this is only 3 matches. But it's 3 consecutive matches, which is weird, considering who we're talking about.
Good clearance. From this position, they can maybe work.
Be great if he can keep this up for the remainder of the season. I don't mind having him having a off game here and there, but he normally has a few in a row.
Kane.
Ooh, after getting a brace, he's up 2. So, fact that
just wondering about the effect of the snow into the player's eyes and seeing
for appears to be continuing. It's good.
It impairs vision, and if it gathers on the ball as well, of course, that's when the ref has to have a look at it.
It's an exhibition here with such great passing.
My keeper had that anyway, but it's good to get out of the box away from where they can make something of it. Maybe I can make something of this? No. That. Again, that could have easily ended up in an own goal. Very seen that happen in this career mode. Anyway, local career mode. Actually, it happens in all. Almost all career modes in these almost. And a lot of matches in almost every league. If there's a league out there that's never had an own goal scored in it, I'd be very, very surprised.
Well, the referee has signaled for halftime, and it's 1-0 here. Second half is on.
Second goal and widening this gap in the second half.
They've got the ball in the middle of the pitch here.
Pepe.
This hammer.
Gonna have to go alone. No one's giving him an option. Second time asking. Kramer first scores again. You can't argue with his good form. You just can't. And it's coinciding with the signing of Traore. If it's a coincidence, then it's a hell of a freaking coincidence. But I am going to go with my gut feeling that it's not a coincidence, and that he's now gonna be trying every single game. And again, have a good performance because he knows that one bad performance could see him out of the team. And you can't look at. You just can't argue it. You just can't argue. I mean,
what a day he's having. 3 goals now. He's been a thorn in the side of the opposition all match, and he thoroughly deserves that hat trick.
Kramer has gone up another level all of a sudden. A few games ago, he would have struggled to score a hat trick. In this game, he's done it with pretty much ease. In game goals back to back.
And the away team want to.
One after another.
Nice bit of footwork,
And he's pretty much secured the 30 points. I mean, until I have another win over NC. Yay.
El Hero Elliot.
All in all, good performance, which will equal a good win, which will equal 3 more points. Maybe PSV will drop some points so I can open the gap.
Inside of the head as well as the outside. Good pass.
It's almost getting to that time of the season where it starts coming to mind. Currently the gap is 18 points. Send that out! Oh, that would have been a fantastic goal. Just freaking hit it! Yes. Keeper pulls off a good save.
And he goes for goal with his head. That's a spectacular save. Not turning the ball around, he's hung on to it.
Really? He can pull off all the saves he wants right now? Oh, because the damage is already well and truly done.
It's a useful ball in. Poor touch and the possession's gone away.
Primer. I suppose he's allowed one miss considering he scored a hat trick. Look at that. Buckingham? What's he doing all the way up here? Mr. Rex Banger run! What can he make of it? Crosses is cleared.
Run back very quickly.
Oh, he went back. Fair play to him. And it's out for a throw. Congolo. Tapia loses the ball just before I can make the challenge.
Counting down towards the end of the 90 minutes. 9 minutes left. And they've got to score soon.
Well, the time for patience.
They can take a break.
Because
Primer has got me.
Well, they might be bringing him off so he can get the
free. That he deserves after such an exception. He won't be losing his spot anytime soon with a hat-trick performance like that.
Be a signal here at the corner.
Especially not considering he has 3 good performances in a row, which, like I said, pretty uncommon for him.
Now he can cross it.
And at least in terms of,
well, it will be dealt with
under me.
The defenders there.
Out. Well,
that's straight at the goalkeeper. Easy.
Shot blocked.
Supported there as he can head it on.
Oh, yeah.
Congolo.
Traore. Can't get into the box, the ball is blocked, and it is, the full time whistle goes.
One team's coming off looking pretty fresh, the other team exhausted.
Primer goes to get the match ball, all after earning it. There we go, nice yellow ball for your friend. Huh. I didn't even realize it. There was a familiar face in the other goal. Well, Brad Jones, former Liverpool goalkeeper. That was weird. I was playing against him the whole time, I didn't even realize. Although, to be fair, I didn't take any. So I didn't notice of his name. Even as I was banging 3 goals in past him. Greninja. I've jumped up into second. Temporarily, perhaps, because PSV haven't played yet. A few of the new contracts that I dished out were accepted. And I was right, PSV have jumped back up into second place. I mean, the gap is still at 18. Oh yeah. I can definitely see that you're gonna play him. But since this is a secondary career mode, I don't give a shit. I won't be here for those 2 seasons, so well, do what you like. Really, I don't give a shit. Regular lineup returns for this game against. I still can't pronounce this team's name. So anyone who can, tell me in the comments. Is it pronounced Hercules? Because I just have a feeling that it's not.
Now you've got your chance to check on the lineup for the home team.
That's why I the first time I played them, I stuck to calling them Ha. And this time, I will call them Ha as well.
Decide to come over a little defensive, this team, but if they're on the front foot, that 3 up front can cause the opposition back 4 some problems.
What will really be funny is getting all 3 points. Now that would be funny. Yeah, avoids the challenge. Come on, give me an option. Send it off the post. Corner? Yes.
Well, he put the signal up there, but I don't think the...
What was that? That was a terrible header. Spotting him.
Back to the training ground to practice that one.
What am I gonna do with him?
What we've got in this game, Alan, is a visiting team that won't be fazed by the atmosphere in this game.
Forward. Oh yeah.
Well, they've got some good individuals at the back, and they've also got great understanding across that back line. He's looking for the cross.
One. Well, Hannah. Oh, it's still Jaric.
The ball deserved perhaps a better
doesn't
response.
Find its way out. The and they have the ball back. But they've given it straight to me. Berg.
It's a real tussle between the two of them to try and get the ball.
N'Golo.
The visiting team today had a good win against this side that they're visiting in the other match between the two clubs earlier in the season.
Not judged to have been fouled. Really
free kick.
Oh, but that's a foul. Well, make up your mind, you biased tit. That's a new one. Berg. Vahana. Ngolo. Come on. Make a run, Elliot. Why is he just standing there? Ngolo. Elliot. Oh. Of course.
He spotted a teammate and he's got the technique as well as the vision to switch the play.
Alamedy.
That's very good link up play.
Dendera. Oh, his shot was blocked. Spirit back. Vahana.
It looks as though that
petered
out a bit now. They'll have to try and raise their game again. They've got to defend at the moment.
Wins another corner.
Because of that deflection. Well, no wonder he's such a popular player.
His
skill is great, but his self-control is...
The old-fashioned short corner and whipping. The technique doesn't work this time.
Sometimes you get criticised for that, but not
this time. Get back quickly. Vahana.
El Hero
Elia. Oh, yeah. Yes, beats the defender with ease. Elia! God damn it!
To move a muscle except to catch it.
Congolo.
Elia.
Elia. This team just doesn't know how to deal with Elia. His pace. Ugh. Oh! It went straight back to me, El Hamidi! When's a corner? Wait, what? That's a corner! Wow! Ooh. So, the referee and the linesman are both against me. Fantastic!
Time now for the second half to start.
Couch. Instantly tackled. Poor touch. I have to make a substitution at some point in this half. Never mind. Because Kramer has done it again. Four goals in two games. Four consecutive games where...
That was a really crisp volley.
He's been on the prowl. This is another good performance. That will be four games in a row. A new best. His current best is three. Which is the current run he's on.
Good contest between these two.
I'm telling you, Traore, he's a rival, has made Kramer suddenly better. And wait, the referee actually acknowledged that FL. Oh, now actually give a card. Thank you. For the red card. For that pretty bad challenge, but hey, yellow, we're getting there. There slowly but surely.
Going to be a substitution here for the home side. And
Buttingham.
Ball's gone again. Elia.
Oh, Elia. Yeah. Dendera. Why did I just... I should have slashed it. Couch. Dendera is offside.
On the shoulder of the last dip.
I paused it, then I didn't make the substitution I wanted to make. I'm gonna bring on Basque for Cal. I only want to make one substitution in that game.
Just got to get it right. It's all about timing.
Yeah, very clearly offside.
But it is a substitution.
I like that Kramer was bang on side. So he would have been the better pass. Oh, the irony.
Here's the cross. Well, the ball deserved perhaps a better response from his teammates.
Easy collect. From the keeper after the header back from Nkongolo. Thank you, and for foul giving. Calamity. Still the damage. Drop it in. Berg! A better connection, and that's a goal.
Again, that possession squandered, really.
But you can't dwell on ifs and buts. There's pass.
Had to tackle there.
Wins a corner. What I am? Oh, that was going in! That was actually going in! After I criticized his headers earlier, that one was actually going in. He's prevented the counter being used to full effectiveness. Kramer, pass, 2-0! I could have gone with Kramer, but Bass again, a better position scores. I have a feeling that the keeper was prepared for a shot. He had very little time to fully react to it. From the shot from Bass. Maybe I would have scored for Kramer, who knows. But the goal and an assist for Kramer, which is just as good. Because he's still involved in both goals. As long as we're scoring goals, we're winning games.
They're looking to make the change. Tries to punch it away.
And that, oh, I couldn't hit it in time. And, well, I did hit it, but the defender was in the way. So, yeah, loses the ball, wins it straight back. Kramer, 3-0, game over. Kramer makes it a hat trick, then a brace. And again, performs. Like, he's a different player. I mean, he's in the right place, his shots are on target and are going in. Seriously, I'm liking this new Kramer. All of a sudden, he's brilliant. He's been average all season. As soon as I bring in another striker who can contest with him for the first team position, he is starting to play. Like he's for being one of the best in the world. As if like magic! That's crazy to think that a player might play better if he thinks his position is in, is up for grabs. Fancy that. Maybe it's a coincidence. I definitely don't think. I think it's just Kramer has upped his performance because he knows if he doesn't keep up great performances, he will lose his spot. It's 4 games in a row for Kramer to have great performances. And in his first 2 matches, it's 2 clean sheets for Iscariot. That'd be great if he can do that for Liverpool. I'm not going to hold my breath, considering we're starting at Arsenal. Can't expect too much. What you can expect is... is two very big games in the next episode. Not only the quarterfinal of the Dutch Cup against Ajax. Next, hoping to avenge what happened in December. I do not forget. And I will have a huge top of the table clash against PSV Eindhoven. So do not miss the next episode. It will probably be one of the most crucial episodes in the whole career mode. So don't you dare miss it. But for this episode, I'm going to sign off by saying thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Hit subscribe if you're new to the channel. So you don't miss any future content. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.